Welcome friends. Today we are going to discuss about lean manufacturing principles. About this we are going to discuss today. So in this topic we'll cover what is lean manufacturing principle, how it is benefited to the concerned company, and how it should be implemented, how it should be maintained. So let's start. This lean manufacturing principle is presented by Fresh Panda, Anil Kumar Sahani. Why lean manufacturing principle? 80% plus waste reduction. The lean manufacturing principle's main target to reduce the wastage in the concerned company or the factory or the continuous production industries. So the lean manufacturing principle, the first target to reduce the wastage which is generated in the company up to 80% plus. So it will give the benefit directly to the company on manufacturing plant anything. Second is 50% lower production cost, means whatever the cost you are implementing, you are investing in the current situation without the lean manufacturing principle. If you apply the lean manufacturing principle, the production cost will reduce by 50%. 80 to 90% reduction in standing inventory. For the every company, we are keeping the inventory in the store. That is the 100% or maybe more than 100%. So if you don't have the any principle for the working, then you are doing the hazardous way and keeping your inventory in surplus condition. Now if you apply the lean manufacturing principle, then 80 to 90% reduction in the standing inventory. Why and how, I will explain in the next slide. 90% lower cost of the quality. Obviously, for the every company, the quality for the every manufacturing factory, the quality is the prime thing. So, to producing a qualitatively good product, you need to invest much cost and you need to be cautious. Cost in the sense of manpower, material and everything's element you can consider it. But by applying the manufacturing lean manufacturing principle, you can go into get it down by 90%. Means your product will be the cheaper and quality will be the good. 50% increased labor productivity. It is obvious if there is a principle by which you are going to work lean, by lean principle, the productivity will increase and obviously labor cost will be get down. So why one manufacturing company, one manufacturing factory need to implement this lean manufacturing principle? these are the elements. So going forward, what is lean manufacturing principle? Now I am going to explain what is the lean manufacturing. Lean manufacturing principle have the main focus to reduce the wastage. If a company generating more wastage, that means indirectly or directly they are wasting his money. Wasting in the sense of manpower, man hours, materials, keeping more extra inventory, scrap generation, or the time frame in which it is not meeting the delivery, mean wasting the time and not meeting the delivery, that impacting the company. So the main focus of lean manufacturing principle is to reduce waste. Lean is a system that is for reducing the waste. We need to generate a system and implement in that company. So lean, what is lean? Lean is a system. Lean is a method. But now we are implemented one system, but the system will work on which basis? System will work on a method by which we are going to reduce the wastage. So lean is a method. Lean is a way of life, means a way of life in the sense of in your life there is a several path of doing work. It is the habituated work in your life. So lean is similar like that. It should be implemented in, and it should be habitual practice in the company. School of thought means this is the brainstorming. Lean principle is nothing but a brainstorming things. You brainstorm and the idea should be systematically implemented in the principle. Means ki school of thought means in a school you're thinking, learning and implementing the ideas. So lean principle is nothing but the school thought. In your factory you need to think what is the process, how it is going on, what will be the effect, what will be the consequences. So by learning from there you can implement and you make the correction in the system, path, working style. So it is school of thought. Now next is lean manufacturing principle is have the several elemental parameter. I'm going to discuss this one by one. I'll be discuss in subsequent slide. Element waste means keep lean principle is related with the eliminate waste. Means focus is to eliminate the waste. I told you the waste in the sense of time, money, material, anything you can think. This Kaizen continuous improvement, I'll detail in these terms in next slide. The Kaizen continuous improvement means ki if there is a problem in a system, whatever the implemented system in your workshop, now there is some loophole. Now you need to grasp, take lesson learned from there and implement them, and continuously it should be improved. If again system fails, you need to take corrective actions and implement the same. So it should be continuously improvement. The Kaizen I'll elaborate in next slide. Respect human elements. Respect human elements means the employee, whoever is with you, respect them. Give them monetary benefits, give the proper attention, give the proper workload. Don't overload the employee who is working under you. Haizunka level production. Haizunka level production means you need to levelize the production. If you have a target of delivery, now you divide it in elemental way that you can easily achieve the target. It should not be come a rush in the last moment, just in time production. Inki production should be accurate in time. One piece flow should be flow in a systematic direction. And quality built in means ki lean manufacturing principle purpose is to build a quality in your product. Pokayoka mistake proofing means ki if there is a mistake in the system, you need to take lesson learned, and those lesson learned you implement so that the mistake may not happen in the coming future. Jidoka, detecting defects through automation. Automate the system in that way so that engineer the system in that way so that you can find the any defect before. Now next is elimination of wastage. What is this? The more waste you eliminate, the more your production saves with every product. That is clear from this line. While you eliminating the wastage more, your production will be saved. Production saves with every product. In the every product, I am giving the example. If a cell need to roll, now I need to buy the plate in that fashion that one cell plate should be marked from the one single plate, or engineered the design in that fashion so that the scrap should not be more, means wastage should not be more. This is the one example. Now inventory wasting, making it break up that the wastage where the wastage in the sense of inventory, wasting space and resources. Inventory means we should not waste the space. The proper utilization of the space will give the more production. And resources in the man, machine, man, material, machinery should be proper utilized, and it should be optimized in the application. Making usable byproduct. What of the byproduct generating from the factory that should be proper utilized. And it should not be produce unusable byproduct. Spreading out your workstation too much, increasing the travel time in between them, you need to assign a workstation in that fashion that travel time in between the workstation should not be more. Such as, I'm giving example, if you are making the cell and deset feature, if the two parts cell is making at the another workstation one and the deset is the producing at the other workstation two, now the workstation one and two should be in such a way that the travel time in between two stations should be less, so that it will be reduce the wastage of time, traveling time. Production queue backing up due to bottleneck. If the continuous production line production, then if at any place, any workstation, there is a bottleneck, it should be backed up so that it should not waste the time. Too many workers being assigned to a limited task. On a task, whatever the workers is required, in the optimized manner, you should assign that much manpower only on that task, because the too many manpower will be there, then manpower wastes, manpower wastes, and there will be no proper output. People will give the assignment to the single worker so that he can understand what his task, otherwise he may not work properly. Next is Kaizen, continuous improvement. Continuous improvement, by continuing to improve your production process, you can reduce waste as much as possible by eliminating whatever bottleneck threaten to pop up and examine which processes are inefficient. If the process is inefficient, what is the cause? There will be many bottlenecks, means material is not available, manpower is not available, there is some problem in machinery. So whatever the challenge coming in between, so whatever the bottleneck is there, so you need to examine it properly, and that is making the process inefficient, so you should take care of that point, so it should be improved properly and continuously. So failure tasks should not be repeated. If any task that making the problem, any mistake happen, then it should not be repeated in the future. So that what action we need to take, we need to take corrective action, we need to give the proper training to the employee, we need to circulate the problem happened, the mistake happened in the working process. So it should aware, the people should aware regarding that issue, so he may not repeat again. Things to be done in proper way with accuracy, lesson to be learned from mistake, and assure it should not be repeated again. The only way to continuously improve your practice is to document and manage your process and procedures first. Processes and procedures, it should be documented. If there is a written things, you need to do the work in this proper sequence. If first, such as example, first you mark the plate, the stamp transfer, then call the inspector, get inspection done, then after cut it. There is a sequence, there is a process of manufacturing. So you need to document it, and it should be get approved by the client, so that mistake may not happen. Okay. I think it is clear. So next is, respect your human elements. I told previously, respect human elements. How you can respect your human element? Without a respect for the humanity and the people in your organization, there is no way you will be able to consistently perform at a high level production. So how means, don't overwork your employee. Never try to give the assignment much. Show them the purpose behind their work, what it achieves. It should be realized to the worker who is working. Align the purpose with their own goals. You should fix a goal and give them a target to do the work accordingly. Maintain high accountability for success and failure. It is very important, because if on the work floor so many people are working, and if you are not making the difference in the good worker and the bad worker, then you are making injustice with the human elements. So the high accountability should be maintained, and it should be reflected in their performance. So there will be a competition, and your production will be high. Get to the root of the problem by taking to the employee and letting them to tell you in their own words. If there is a problem, the employee have a problem, let them speak and you listen it and take action accordingly. Ensure their task have as little friction as possible. So tasks must be in that fashion. Challenge them without demanding. Give stability but also variety of their task. Stability and variety of their task. If a people become monotonous, the efficiency of the people will be less. So give them, and it should not be then every time frequently you change their task. So the people getting some problem inside them. So there will be the variety of task, but the stability in that task. So in that way you can honor your human element. Now the Hajunka label production. Hajunka is the Japanese word which means labeling production. In turn, this means that no matter what happens, your output remains the same every day. Labeling production means the fixed target of a day should be maintained, whatever the consequences, whatever the problem in between them, but our daily production target should be met. So what you need to do? Carefully calculate and adjust your production rate to match the average order delivery. Average order delivery should be cascaded in that way, so that you need to meet the last target. Carefully need to calculate the safety production time, what is the main effective production time, you need to calculate them carefully so that it may not affect your final delivery. Keep your production consistent and avoid last time rush. It is very important. The safety production time, fluctuation time is a key for the time delivery of the project. It is very important. If you wrong calculating the effective production time, safely production time, then there will be fluctuation in the delivery of the project. Just in time production is one of the many school of the process. That's why I told you previously it is the school of thought, means key school of process. Innovation focused on reducing waste. Nothing is completed in excess, as that in considered waste. Think standing inventory. Just in time means ki whatever material is present with you, just use it and finish it. So there is no any extra material for the future projects. Whatever the project material you buy for that current project, you use them. That is the JIT. Break your operation into smaller sets of tasks. No excess inventory to be retained. Every available inventory to be used in time. Prime target is to be reduce wastage. So, if you are using your current inventory in the current project, there will be no extra inventory and there will be no waste. So what is the prime target? To reduce the wastage. One piece flow is the lean take on production queues and WIP, WIP, work in progress process. By limiting your WIP to a single item, you can greatly increase your efficiency and the quality associated with the end result. How? Break down your production line and several workstation. Travel time between the workstation are as limited as possible, easily through the optimized floor layout. So during the setup of your workstation workflow, you should optimize layout of your floor workshop so that there will be no wastage of time, unnecessary movement should be reduced. So this is the one piece flow. The one flow should be in proper way and takes to group and spread the work as evenly as possible between station. This is very important. Maximum unproductive time can be reduced by this proper layout. Operation gap between two workstation to be optimized. So I hope it is clear. Now quality building. The concept of having quality built into your manufacturing process is key to running an efficient yet successful business. The business depend on the quality product and timely delivery. These are the two backbones of your business. If it is bad, your business may not run. So avoid human error. To build a quality in the system, you need to avoid human error. For avoiding the human error, you need to take proper action, you need to make a proper principles, you need to make a proper procedures, and it should be approved. Proper inspection and improvement, mistake proofing your process, automatically detecting abnormalities, that is the ZDOCA. Pukayuka mistake proofing. Mistake proofing pukayuk is a Japanese term. Roughly, mistake proofing is the one of the technique used to build quality into lean process B day for the manufacturing workflow or otherwise. The idea in that every process can be engineered to inherently prevent mistakes, either through re-engineering tasks to suit a standard format or by including specific measures which make sure that mistakes are caught early and corrected. I hope it is clear. The process should be engineered in such a way that the mistake that may happen in near future, it can be caught earlier so that you can take a corrective action. ZDOCA, detecting defects through automation. Detecting defects. Complementing Pukayuka is the ZDOCA. The principle that most defects can be automatically detected by the completely remove human error from the equation. In possible process, the machine needs to involve to detect the defects automatically. If the defects automatically detected, I am giving the example of the defect may automatically detected. If a machine have a hole, in that you need to put the stud bolt, but a stud bolt have no head and a bolt has head. So if I am putting the stud bolt, that the design should be in that way that a stud bolt may go but the main bolt may not go. So automatically it will be detected during the fit-up that we need to install the stud bolt, not bolt. So this should be the way to detecting the automatically the defects, that this ZDOCA tells us. I hope it is clear. Now, the lean manufacturing cycle. The five steps in the lean manufacturing cycles are: identify value, define what the value to that production, map the value streams, identify all steps in your process and eliminate those that does not create value. Very important mapping of the value stream, because if the steps which is not value added, it should not be involved in that. Create flow, workflow should be there. Flow, make the value steps occur in tight sequence to provide as much as value to the production as quickly as possible. Establish pull. Make it so that production process to pull each sequence. Seek perfections. Strive for perfections by using continuous improvement, eliminating waste, making reliable process, and generally following the principles we covered earlier. So these are the five steps. Now thank you. That is the end. Thank you. like, subscribe, press the bell button on the channel Fresh Funder so that you can get the notification. I'll continuously give the ideas regarding the engineering processes. Thank you.